you've mentioned these NAD boosters, and we probably should definitely get into that. But
well, they're central too, because as I mentioned, the proteins, many of them, like the sirtuins, who are moving around, controlling the epigenome, you want to stabilize that as best you can. Animals like whales and naked mole rats have a very stable epigenome, so this moving around of proteins and epigenomic noise accumulating. If we're exercising, we're taking NAD boosters, we do slow that process down, I believe.
Well, let's talk about what NAD boosters are. So the precursors for NAD, right?
Sure.
We make NAD in our bodies.
We do. And so NAD is recycled in the body because there's grams of it. You can't eat that much easily. And there's a cycle. It's called the salvage pathway of NAD. And it all starts with nicotinamide, which is a form of niacin and vitamin B3. But you can't just, well, you can, but it's not very effective. Just overdose on vitamin B3 because you need other things to make the big molecule NAD. So NAD is, the reason it's called nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide is that it's got these three main components, and the dinucleotide is related to DNA, right? But that's beside the point. It's a big molecule, so that if you give a big molecule to cells, it doesn't get taken up. So we don't feed animals NAD, and we don't just feed them nicotinamide, which is the little N part of NAD, because it's too small in that you need these other parts. So NMN and NR are two molecules, so it stands for nicotinamide mononucleotide, which is essentially the precursor, the immediate precursor to NAD. If you give a cell NMN, it will be taken up by a transporter, which was just discovered by my buddy Shinamai. We used to work together at MIT, now he's at WashU. A few weeks ago, he wrote about it, I wrote about it, that there's a transporter that sucks up NMN. And the NMN is converted within one step to NAD in the cell. And now it's locked, it's a big molecule, it's locked inside the cell. And that step is carried out by an enzyme. It's got a name, it's called an MPT. And that enzyme goes up under stress and calorie restriction. And in yeast, it's the same step. And so we showed years ago that step of conversion of NMN to NAD, or in yeast, nicotinic acid to NAD, is the critical step for boosting NAD when you're going through your circadian rhythms, when you exercise, when your cells are stressed. And without that step, you don't get the benefits of calorie restriction, and your organs start to get old. So what is NR? So NR is fairly popular. A lot of people have heard of it. It stands for nicotinamide riboside. And all it is it's just a smaller version of NMN without a phosphate on there, so there's no phosphorus on it. So if you take NR, your body has to first put on a phosphorus, and then it has to basically link two of them together to make the NAD. So with all that said,
NR gets converted into NMN first and then into NAD?
Yes, it has to, yeah. But NR and NMN have both been shown to raise the NAD levels in animals and in humans as well. And there's small nuances about the differences, but they both seem to be effective. Not just in humans, actually, I should say in mice, but in yeast, they work as well, which is nice.